And then this is really interesting because you guys know how much I love fasting. So I ended up stumbling upon this research because I wanted to know if we fasted, did vitamin D levels go up or down? Dr. Mindy here, and on this video, I want to talk about vitamin D from a whole new perspective. I want to show you some science that is showing that when our vitamin D levels dip low, it makes us not only insulin resistant, but it can make us leptin resistant as well. So when you're looking at weight loss resistance, we've got to bring vitamin D back to the conversation. So on this video, I'm going to show you what the science says, and then I'm going to talk about some of the best ways to get your vitamin D levels up. And if you're new to my channel, I just want to say welcome. We talk about all things fasting here. We talk about everything you can do on a personal level to bring health back to your life. And as always, I am on a mission this year, you guys, to get 1 million people to build a fasting lifestyle. So if you love this information, send it out into the world. If you're new to my channel, subscribe. We are one big community that are all banding together to take personal action around our health. So welcome. Okay. If you're not familiar with the videos I've done before, go back and look at some of the playlists that I've done. We just got done doing a fast training week where we talked about leptin resistance. And just to kind of bring back to the conversation, we have two hormones that we have to have in balance if we want to lose weight. One is insulin. You guys have heard a lot about insulin resistance, and the other is leptin. Insulin is what stores the fat. Leptin is the hormone that burns the fat. So if we want to get out of weight loss resistance, we need both of these hormones to be sensitive. So here's some interesting research that I found. The first one, it was a meta-analysis, so it was like a review, and they looked at all the articles published on vitamin D and insulin resistance on PubMed, which if you're not familiar with PubMed, that is the search engine that we go to get peer-reviewed science articles. And they looked at everything from 1980 all the way up to 2019, all the studies that were done on vitamin D and insulin resistance. And they found two major pieces here, looking at all of those studies. One, if you are low in vitamin D, it affected your pancreatic beta cells. These are the cells that have control over insulin actually being secreted. The second thing they noted was that when vitamin D levels go low, it affected the responsiveness of your cells to insulin. So when your vitamin D is low, you're not only having trouble making insulin, and if you can't make insulin, glucose is going to get stored as fat, but you also have trouble with the cells being responsive to the insulin that is being made. So if you're not familiar with insulin resistance, it is at the root of all immune problems, all weight loss resistant issues. It leads to chronic disease. It's why we're seeing such this pandemic has taken over the world, is because insulin resistance is rampant and we've got to get you insulin sensitive again. And what I found so interesting about this study, which I'll link in my notes, is that we're seeing this low vitamin D has a correlation between the levels that your vitamin D is at and how insulin resistant you are. Now, I went on to look at, well, what about leptin resistance? Sure enough, same thing, that they saw the lower your vitamin D levels, the higher your leptin levels. So remember, leptin is the hormone that will tell your brain to burn fat. And it needs to be, it's released from the fat cells and it should go up into the brain and tell the hypothalamus, hey, I'm down here. So you want this to be a very efficient system. Well, just having extra leptin doesn't mean you're a better fat burner. Doesn't mean you're gonna get out of fat loss resistance anytime soon. You need that leptin to be sensitive. And vitamin D is key to both insulin and leptin sensitivity. Okay, so what do we have to do if we're worried about our vitamin D? And there's three things I want to start off by telling you. One is that if you're struggling with your weight, I don't want you to overlook this key nutrient. So know your vitamin D levels. Go get them tested. We'll talk about what the levels mean here in a second. Once you've tested your levels, then let's create a strategy for it. I'm going to show you my favorite strategies here in 1 second, so sit tight. And then the last point that I want to deliver to you guys is there's a lot of controversy over what is the proper level. And you know that most people would say 30 is pretty good. We measure vitamin D in nanograms. 30 is pretty great. But we want you over 50 for insulin resistance. We want you over 50 for COVID symptoms, for strong immunity. So on this video, I want to show you how you get over 50. That's what we're looking for. So there are four major ways that I like to bring vitamin D levels up. The first is just good old-fashioned foundation of lifestyle. So make sure that you're eating good fats, not bad fats. If you are eating a lot of bad fats, I don't care how much supplementation you take in, that vitamin D is not going to get into the cells. So our favorite way to get good fats is to lean into some high quality fats like the avocado oils and sunflower, seed oils like Andreas seed oils. We have one that we recommend that's an immune boosting seed oil. We'll put a link in the notes for that. So add in your good oils, take out your bad oils. Second thing is you want to keep your carbohydrate load down. So you don't always have to go keto, but we don't want you on high processed, high refined, that raise your sugar levels. So watch your blood sugar. Make sure that your blood sugar is trending under 100 at least. It's not trending into 120, 130. Then you really, the third piece of that, of this foundational level, is making sure that you are sensitive to not having too many toxins get into your body. So the fake foods, the processed foods with the chemicals in them, they're going to make your cells more resistant to vitamin D. So that's foundational. Before you go trying to trick out supplementation, I want you to really work on those three principles. Okay, second thing that we've heard a lot is get out in the sun. But this is highly variable. There are three variables that will play in how much vitamin D your body can make from the sun. The first is how much sun you're getting. Like, you got to get out at noon in the high sun. You got to have about 30 minutes of exposure. You got to have it be on skin, and you got to do that every day. So if you're committed to that, you can really bring your vitamin D levels up. The second is, the darker your skin, the less you'll take that UVB light and turn it into vitamin D. So you're going to have to probably lean into more supplementation if your skin is darker. And then the third part of the skin exposure is those of you that live in an area with a lot of air pollution. Air pollution can block the UVB light from getting into our skin and can affect how much vitamin D we get. So if you have dark skin, you live in a big city, and you're not getting out every day in the sun at noon, then you're gonna need to look at supplementing with some vitamin D. Now, we can supplement with food, but the food that you gotta eat to get your vitamin D levels up, not so yummy. So they're your oily fishes, your sardines, your mackerels, your salmon. Salmon's not bad, but if you love those, then awesome, go for it. I personally am not a huge fan of that, but that's an option. Second option for foods that raise vitamin D is liver. Okay, also not a huge fan of eating liver, but thank you to Dr. Paul Saladino for his company, Heart and Soil. They have an incredible liver supplement. So if you are really working hard to bring your vitamin D levels up, you're committed to getting it over 50, I'd look at Paul's Heart and Soil supplements. Just put liver supplements in the comments and we'll send you a link for that. The other one, for those of you that eat meat, grass-fed beef can really bring your vitamin D levels up. But outside of food, out of those foods, that's pretty much it. That's all you can do to bring vitamin D up. Which leads us at the last point, and what most people realize when they've measured their vitamin D, they want to bring it up, is you're going to have to lean into supplementation. But there's some tricks to this as well. So for example, whenever you supplement with vitamin D, you want to increase vitamin K. So vitamin K and vitamin D together will improve absorption. Add some vitamin C into that, and now you're improving absorption even more. The second part of this is you want to have a good diversity of microbiome in your gut. So you have to have good gut diversity. Well, not a lot of people have great gut diversity, so you may want to take your vitamin D with probiotic. What we do in our office is we use a product called DB3 and mix it with a great probiotic called MBC. If you want a link to those supplements, just put vitamin D and probiotic supplement in the comments, and again, we'll send you the link. And then this is really interesting because you guys know how much I love fasting. So I ended up stumbling upon this research because I wanted to know if we fasted, did vitamin D levels go up or down? And they've actually found in research that you can improve your vitamin D levels by as much as 50% over a 2 to 3 month period by taking your vitamin D supplement with a meal. So this is one of those supplements that it's more powerful when you eat. It's even more powerful when you eat a fatty meal and now you take your vitamin D, that it'll get, it's more accessible to the cell. So if you take a supplement with vitamin K, with vitamin C, and you're eating a lot of polyphenol, probiotic, prebiotic foods, and then with that meal, you're taking a vitamin D supplement, now we're maximizing our vitamin D reserves. So it's not as simple as supplementation, but what I'm finding after this has been a year, you guys, we've been in this pandemic for a year, and I've been analyzing why people are so immune compromised. And I am convinced now more than ever that we all need to be fasting and we all need to be minding our vitamin D levels. And if we do those two things, then we also are able to come out of metabolic syndrome, which is another major precursor or comorbidity for the virus that we're all dealing with. So there's a lot of nuance here, but what I want you to understand is that if there was one vitamin you needed to bring up for weight loss, for immune system, to prevent cancer, it is vitamin D, and this is how you do it. So let me know if that's helpful. And as always, you guys, Menopause Reset, April 6th, pre-order. So if you want to know the interesting thing, by the way, about vitamin D is it acts like a hormone in your body. So we talk all about hormones and vitamin D, microbiome, detoxing, fasting, a diet variation. I show you the lifestyle you should be living over 40 in the Menopause Reset. So if you want a link on how you can pre-order that, just put Menopause Reset in the comments and my team will get it for you. So vitamin D, it's your friend, but it's not as simple as taking a supplement. So hope that helps.